Hey guys, we're back with day 22? 22? Yeah, day 22 of our 31 days of Halloween. Today we have one of the more... I don't know, I thought this was going to be a fun one. I really thought so. Instead, this is a dark and pretty twisted movie, but it was fucking fantastic. Today we've got The Devil's Candy. First of all, I just want to say thank you to Cadaver Club, because that was the whole reason. I think it was... Ooh, I hope I don't say the wrong one. You know what? Scratch this. Thank you to whoever happened to recommend this to me, just so that I don't accidentally name the wrong person. This was not originally on my list for this month. I've had it on my Netflix queue for fucking ages, but this recommendation finally got me to pull the trigger, and thank God I did, because this movie was fucking awesome. From start to finish. I think it's ever since Can't Hardly Wait, I really liked Ethan Embry, and he fucking kills it in this movie. Everything about his performance is so just against what I ever have seen him in, and it was just fantastic. Now, he's like, I don't know why, but he's like shirtless for 90% of the movie. I think they're trying to do some weird Jesus motif with him, because he even has like long hair and a beard, but it's just like odd. And it got to the point where I'm just like, dude, put on a shirt. Like, what is happening here? Even a wife beater, put something on. I really enjoyed the performances, and the evil guy in this, he shows up in so many different films. He's like this great character actor. He finally gets a chance to be more of like a more important role. He's the main bad guy, and he gets quite a bit of screen time, and that was just cool to see. I love character actors getting to do a little more than just some bit role, so that was really cool. And honestly, the whole movie is just so good. I think that the reason I thought this was gonna be a lot more lighthearted is because it was recommended to me this time, and it's been recommended to me in the past because of Deathgasm. They have like similar metal motifs, but Deathgasm is much more of like a parody and fun, and this one's much more serious and pretty fucking sick and twisted, because you have kids getting killed in this, and it gets to be pretty brutal, but it's honestly just really well done from start to finish. And if you're looking for one of the better indie films that still hits a fucking metal vibe, definitely check this out, because it caught me by surprise, and it's a hell of a lot darker than I ever expected. Now, tomorrow we've got something that, the reviews are pretty mixed for it, but, so we'll see who you guys end up liking it. I'm pretty mixed on it too, essentially, but we'll see. For day 23, we've got Beyond the Gates. Let's see if I'm the only one that actually end up liking this one. It's based on Letterboxd. It seems like I might be. We'll see you tomorrow.
Hey, you can feel free to hit that subscribe button below and follow me on Twitter, Instagram, or Letterboxd. I am at ZombieVictim on all of them. Thanks.